What are some of the factors that Paradise Energy uses in selecting some of these solar panels?
So when we look at a brand, Warren, obviously price is important. It's not the only thing. It's not the most important thing, but it is a piece to consider. We look at that. We also look at, you know, how long has this company been around? Do they have a track record of producing products that are reliable, that perform well? What's the warranty like of the product? What's their customer service been like? Where are they located? We really place a lot of value on companies that are located either in North America or in Europe. That's one of our one of the goals that we have. We don't always do that, but that's one of the things that we take in mind. Where do they manufacture their products is another thing to consider as well.
And also their financial stability.
Their financial stability. You know, do they have a track record of making a profit, or have they been struggling for years? You know, and how does that affect R&D and some of those kinds of things?
And then what factors does Paradise Energy use when designing a system?
So once we have those brands selected, when we go to design an actual system, we break it down even farther.
Okay.
You know, we'll look at maybe an all-black panel for a residential roof mount.
Right.
When aesthetics are more important. We might look at the efficiency of the panel. You know, when you have limited space, are you willing to pay more money for a more efficient panel?
Right.
Or do you have plenty of space where you can have a panel that's not quite as efficient, but then you have a lower cost? You know, that's something that we take in mind. Typically, we use larger panels on ground mounts that are easier to get to with forklifts and such, and then smaller panels on a roof mount that are maybe more difficult to get the panels to their installed location. So that's something to keep in mind as well. And then what are the environmental conditions like? Like, how will that panel perform under high temperatures? How will it perform overall? Again, are we looking at maximum production and we're willing to pay the cost for it?
Right.
Or are we looking at maybe a little bit less production, but then a lower cost?
And of course, if the customer's requesting or requires domestic content, that comes into play into your selection of solar panels.
Absolutely, yeah. If you need a domestic content cell, that's really gonna limit the number of brands that, that have availability of that.
So here's the moment we've all been waiting for. Drum roll, please. What are the top four solar panel manufacturers that we offer here at Paradise Energy?
The top four, Warren, are QCells, SEG, AXITEC, and Silfab.
Let's talk about SEG first. What's a great use case for an SEG panel?
SEG is quickly becoming our go-to panel, Warren. They have great options for roof mounts, ground mounts, all black options. We started using them because they were the only or the primary mid-sized commercial solar panel on the market. And what we found is that they have great solutions in really all of our market segments.
And how are they in terms of efficiency and production?
Efficiency is pretty good. They're above average, 22 to 22.65% or so, which is pretty good. They have good temperature coefficients, which means it's going to perform well in hot conditions. So it's a pretty good performing panel.
And what about their warranties?
Warranties are also pretty good. 15-year on the product and 30-year on production, which is good.
What about their customer service?
Customer service is pretty good. We haven't had a lot of issues with their products, so we haven't interacted with their customer service a lot. But what we've experienced so far is pretty good.
Where are SEG panels made?
They're made right here in the U.S. They have some U.S. manufacturing. And we actually did a tour of their facility out in Texas.
Yeah.
Pretty impressive facility.
It is.
And if you're interested, the video is in the description below if you want to see more about that. So they do have some manufacturing here in the U.S. Now, they don't make any U.S. cells, any cells in the U.S. for their modules, which means that they're not eligible for ground mount projects for the domestic content tax credit adder.
Right.
So that's one thing they don't currently have. They do have manufacturing here, and they do have manufacturing in Southeast Asia as well.
And in terms of pricing?
In terms of pricing, it's pretty good. They're a very competitively priced panel.
All right, let's jump into AXITEC. What are some good options for AXITEC?
So AXITEC is an economical option. They have some good roof mount modules, some good ground mount modules, some good all black modules for residential systems. So they kind of have the full range of product as well.
And how do they compare in terms of performance and efficiency?
Performance isn't going to be quite as good. They're about 21 to 21.3% efficient. They're going to have average temperature coefficients. Now, AXITEC typically brings newer products to market slower.
Okay.
So I'm guessing as the year progresses, they're going to come out with some product that's more efficient and that has better temperature coefficients. But right now, they lag in both those areas a bit.
And what about their customer service and their warranties?
Their warranties is average, 15 yeah. years in the product, 25 years in production. And again, you know, we'll see if they come out with anything newer and greater later in the year. As far as customer service, bar none, their customer service is excellent.
Okay.
We've had a close relationship with them. We've worked with them for years. Their customer service is very, very good.
And where are they manufactured?
They do some manufacturing in Southeast Asia.
Okay.
They also have manufacturing in the Middle East right now as well. They do not have any domestic content cells, and as far as I know, no plans to go that route.
And then where do they fall in terms of pricing?
In terms of pricing, it's a pretty economical panel.
Okay.
From the cost perspective, they're going to be your best option.
All right. What about Silfab?
Silfab is a really good option for ground mounts that require domestic content. So okay. that's really the reason why we're using the product, because they have a cell manufacturing facility right here in the U.S. where they make U.S. cells and put them in U.S. manufactured modules, which can help customers get that 10% domestic content adder for ground mounts.
And their efficiency and performance?
Excellent performance. Efficiency of 21.1%, which isn't as high as some, but they have excellent temperature coefficients.
And what about their warranty and customer service?
Again, their warranty is excellent. 25 yep. years in the product, 30 years on performance, very, very good. Our experience with them with customer services, they've been good. Now, again, we have a small sample size. We haven't installed any of these newer modules with a domestic content cell. We have some experience with them over the years. And as far as we know, their customer service has been reasonable.
And then in terms of pricing?
In terms of pricing, they're going to be your most expensive option. And again, okay. that's because they're made right here in the U.S. and Canada.
And they qualify for the domestic content.
And they qualify for the domestic content. Now, I will say this. They have very limited availability. We were fortunate to secure some supply. Whether we'll have enough supply to meet the demand this year is to be seen, but we do have some supply of their product.
So let's talk about Hanwha QCells. What's a good use case for Hanwha QCells?
So first of all, Warren, let me just mention, at the beginning I said that we like to use North American brands and European brands, and that is true.
Yeah.
Now, QCells is a South Korean brand. Now, we're still very comfortable with that country. We're still very comfortable with the company itself. Very strong brand. They've been in solar for a long time. And I also mentioned, too, Hanwha QCells used to be our number one panel.
Right.
Like, they were our primary use.
Yeah.
We would use their product over a lot of others, typically. They've shifted their focus more to utility scale. Still a great company, great product, great panel, but they've shifted their focus, and so we've started using a lot of other brands. And so right now, the only time that we really use Hanwha QCells is when a customer requests that brand, because it is a popular brand.
How do they compare in terms of performance and efficiency?
In terms of performance and efficiency, I would say they have above average performance.
Right.
We're looking at an efficiency of about 21 and 22.4%, which is pretty good, and good temperature coefficients overall.
And what about their warranties?
Warranty, I would say, is average, 12 years in the product, and then between 25 to 30 on the production side.
And the customer service?
Customer service, again, is average.
Okay.
We've had some really good experiences with their team. We've had a challenging experience or two with their team.
Okay.
They'll come through overall.
Yeah.
But we've had a few challenges with their customer service team.
And where are they manufacturing the panels?
They are manufacturing right here in the U.S., which again, is pretty yeah. cool. South Korean company manufacturing in the U.S. They do have limited domestic content cells available.
Right.
Very limited. And again, typically they're focusing that on the utility scale side of things.
And then finally, where do they compare in terms of pricing?
In terms of pricing, they're going to be a little more expensive than most of the other brands.
All right, Larry. So give us a quick recap on the top four solar panel brands for 2025.
So top four, I would say the top is SEG, hands down. We're going to use that module for roof mounts. They have a great mid-size module for that. They have a great larger module for ground mounts, utility scale, you know, size projects. Then they have a great all-black module for residential roof mounts as well. Silfab is another great brand. They have a great product that has domestic content cells that can help our customers get the domestic content tax credit on ground mounts. AXITEC has a pretty good module for ground mounts as well. They also have a really good all-black roof mount option for residential projects. And then finally, QCells. They have, like I said, they have a great brand, great product, great performance, but we primarily use them only when requested.
So there you have it. Those are our top four solar panels of 2025. If you want to see how solar panels are made SEG Solar invited us for an exclusive behind-the-scenes tour of their Texas manufacturing facility, and we brought our cameras along. Watch now using the link in the description below. At Paradise Energy, we're a family-owned, full-service solar company helping businesses, farmers, and homeowners across the Mid-Atlantic save with every sunrise. If you're ready to talk solar, connect with one of our local experts using the link in the description below. Before you go, like this video and drop a comment to let us know what you learned. Thanks for watching.